Developed by Larry Connors, the Connors RSI is a great tool for reversal trading on the lower time frames. It augments the traditional RSI with components that measure the trend duration and the magnitude of the price change. I'll explain how the Connors RSI is calculated, then use it to program a mean reversion strategy for the dollar Canadian.
The Connors RSI was developed to detect short-term overbought and oversold conditions. The team at Connors Research deemed the regular 14-period RSI to be too slow for this purpose. The Connors RSI is made up of three components. The first is a regular 3-period RSI of prices, which normalizes momentum on a 0 to 100 scale. The second component measures the trend duration. First, count the number of consecutive higher or lower closes. For example, if there are 5 consecutive higher closes, the streak is plus 5. If there is no price change, the streak is reset to 0. Then apply the 2-period RSI to the closing streak to normalize the value from 0 to 100. The third component measures the magnitude of the price change. It ranks the current price change against all other price changes within the last 100 periods. For example, if 80 of the last 100 price changes are lower than the current price change, you get 80%. If the current price change is large and positive, this value will be close to 100. Finally, you obtain the Connors RSI by averaging these three components. You could, of course, tweak the default parameters of 3, 2, and 100 if you want a faster or slower indicator. The Connors RSI isn't included in MetaTrader by default, but I have left a download link for the MQ4 and MQ5 files in the description. Compared to the regular RSI, the Connors RSI is more volatile. Connors recommends 90 and 10 to denote overbought and oversold levels, respectively, unlike 70 and 30 for the regular RSI. There is an opportunity to go short when the Connors RSI exceeds 90, and long when it falls below 10. Let's make use of this to program a complete mean reversion strategy. Here is the logic. I am betting that short-term overbought or oversold conditions will revert to the mean. For longs, I am looking for the Connors RSI to fall below 10 for at least 2 consecutive bars. Given how volatile this RSI is, this 2-bar condition is a great way to reduce the number of false signals. I will add in a 50-period Donchian breakout condition. This means I will only go long if the current close is below the lowest low over the last 50 periods, another indication of an oversold market. If the above conditions are met, I will place a limit order at the previous low, valid for 3 bars. Trade management will be a simple 60 pip profit target and stop loss. Here's how a long trade looks. Programming in algowizard is straightforward as usual. The Connors RSI uses the default parameters. The oversold threshold is 10, and the number of consecutive bars is set to 2. For the 50-period Donchian breakout condition, select the lowest low and use a shift of 2. The entry and exit prices are then set. Finally, backtesting over the 15-minute dollar Canadian over 10 years yields the following results. The strategy doesn't trade frequently since the Donchian breakout condition is pretty stringent, but the return over maximum drawdown ratio of 5 is decent. For more complete and backtested strategies, be sure to like, subscribe or buy me a coffee. For mean reversion using pivot points, check out the video at the top right. If trend following is your cup of tea, check out the QQE strategy at the bottom.